At the Louisiana University's Marine Consortium Ocean.com event in 2018, a group of scientists and science communicators loaded onto a bus and traveled to meet the members of the Pointeshen Indian tribe. Several of the 680 tribal members provided us stories of their history, as well as their current challenges and what gives them hope as they continue to live on the Louisiana coast. There are multiple complex issues this community faces. The Pointeshen are identified as climate refugees, although the tribe itself and their island in the bayou is not federally recognized. It has been an ongoing struggle since 1994 for this tribal community to obtain this much-needed federal recognition for protection and financial resources. After spending an incredible evening with the Pointeshen Indian tribe, I decided to use a simple table runner pattern to tell a story about the land, the plants, and family. The dark blue on the border and as the first and last stripe, and as the smaller stripes in between the patterned fabrics, represents one of the official colors of the state of Louisiana. The other official colors are white and gold. Stripe number one represents the land that the Pointeshen live off of. Their ancestors were all farmers, fishermen, and hunters. Although the people rely on both the land and water for hunting alligators, fishing, and catching shrimp, crabs, and oysters, this quilted story focuses on the farming of the land. Stripe number two represents the rising sea level, one of the reasons behind coastal loss for the Pointeshen tribal members. Stripe number three is a white pattern with dots, representing the introduction of salt from the rising water level. Stripe number four shows mud cracks, representing a land that can no longer be farmed the same way or with the same crops because of saltwater intrusion. Their fruit trees and pecan trees are examples of what can no longer grow in this area from the saltwater. Stripe number five shows packets of seeds, representing a plan to continue to grow as a community in this location. The tribal members are clear that they want to adapt in place, believing that the real solution is to work with the natural environment, even though they are fully aware that plants will struggle to grow. Stripe number six represents the tools that the Pointeshen will use to source their food by planting community gardens. Stripe number seven is one of the planned additions to their plant growing, using elevated greenhouses to protect the plants from saltwater intrusion and storm flooding. Okay, so there isn't a perfect fabric to represent elevated greenhouses, but go with me on this. These are green buildings in air. You can see it, right? Stripe number eight is for the vegetables being grown by the community. Stripe number nine is a plant pattern fabric representing the traditional medicinal plants that have been used by the tribe for generations. The Pointeshen are planning to build a medicinal garden as the plants are getting more difficult to find in nature. The color red is known to represent joy, life, and health. Stripe number 10 is for the strong sense of family among the tribal members they shared during our visit. The adults of the Pointeshen wish to teach their children gardening and expose them to their land and culture. They want to hold on to the sense of family. And it is clear that tribal members want to give back to their own community by trying to restore the environment. For example, we heard from 20-year-old tribal member Pete, who is currently in college studying environmental science. He has seen a barrier island disappear in his lifetime and wants to try to restore what has been lost. The woven pattern represents strong family ties, and the color red is for determination, passion, and strength. A fabric with a pattern of hands was selected for the back of the quilt to represent a story from one of the members of the tribe. We learned from the Pointeshen that in this area, everyone spoke Indian French as their first language and sometimes their only language, with each bayou having its own dialect. They do not have an Indian language that they speak, but one tribal member joked that their second language is speaking with their hands, which is what they have to do to signal and communicate with each other when they are out on the shrimp boats. This story brought a smile to all of our faces and a laugh from the group, and I felt this fabric was a perfect addition to the quilt. This is my story of coastal optimism, a story of a community that is committed to remaining on their ancestral land to grow traditional plants, requiring adaptation and restoration. So thank you to the members of the Pointe-Aux-Chenes Indian Tribe for sharing your time, your history, and your hospitality.